Generally, no, but every once in a while, yes. And usually studios will have Google reference, they should. Well, either, like, if you're current, if it's been a long time, they usually have the file, or they can go through a past episode and pull something up. That helps. But generally,
what's your take on line read? Do you like the line read as a director? And as an actor, do you like when directors will line read?
As a director, I don't like to line read. But I will line read certain actors. The purpose of a line read is if, here's the thing. Anytime you want to direct somebody to say something, right? To emote a certain way. You're trying to describe, you use words because you use words describe what they're coming from internally to read. Sometimes you have a read in your head. The read in your head is that read because of all these other emotional things that are dictating that. Every once in a while your brain farts and you can't find the words to describe why you just want that sound, you know? But so when I say sound, I mean music of the line. You guys know what I mean? Inflection or whatever. The reason why the director I don't like giving line reads is because what ends up happening lots of times is parody, which means they just copy exactly what you did, and then there's no emotion behind it, and then that wasn't the whole purpose of the direction, you know. So, however, some actors are really good, and they just realize once they hear the music, they realize, oh, it's this emotion. You know, and you can give them a line read, and they do it, and they're not just mimicking you. They're hearing the music, and then interpreting that, and letting it sink in, and have the music of the line justify internally what they're feeling. You know, so as an actor, I don't mind a line read because if they're hearing something, I process it. I mean, that's how I work when I get a line read. I'm not insulted at all because I understand that sometimes also you can say something and give direction, and two people's interpretation of the same emotion comes out differently. So it could be something as simple as that. I think line reading, the reason you don't give them because they're a crutch. But there are times when it's appropriate. The other thing that I've also realized is that it's much easier to give somebody of the opposite sex a line because they're not going to sound the way it is, so they tend to not be just mimicking it. Also children, because children have a hard time reading. So if they have a script and that they're struggling with the words, reading them, they know all the words, but they're so focused on reading, if you just say it to them, kind of in the way that, you know, with the emotion tension, they for some reason don't end up, most of them don't parrot you. They make it their own and say it how, you know, child actors tend to do that. So those are kind of like the exceptions.
What is your favorite How to Teach a Mia series?
I think it's original. That's my favorite. And my favorite episode is Zero. You're telling me this 5 minutes, right? Not that you want to high five.
No, I'm just asking a question.
Oh, you're asking a question. Uh-huh.
Okay. Speaking of favorites, what's your top three favorite series and why?
Top three? Oh, that's so hard. Oh, God, that's so hard. I really like Kojo. Because I love Sana, the character. It's just really so funny. And it's also like not on break, like in the session. Yes, I do. My top two.